the 7th Division of Thomas. David was a man who, at a billion times past, was confronted with multiple problems. David was a man who fully trusted in God. No matter how many times he might have messed up, he trusted in God. And I'm here to tell you right now, it's not about what you've done in your past. It's about what you want to do in your future. And faith is the substance of things hoped for, and the evidence of things not seen.
Glory.
Faith is something you can't put in your pocket.
All right.
You can't put it in a bag and take it home with you. Faith is something you've got to believe in your heart and understand by what you say you believe in your heart.
Right.
In the 27th division, right verse 1.
The Lord is my life and my salvation. Whom shall I fear?
No matter what you're going through. Now the psalmist said here, the Lord is my light and my what?
Salvation.
Amen. His covenant promise was to take us to glory.
Amen.
Then he says, whom shall I fear? Or what shall I fear?
Right.
Who can stand against me when I trust in God?
Amen.
Now keep in mind, faith is some the substance of things hoped for. If you hope for something, you don't already have it. But you're hoping for it. But you believe it's going to come because you're walking by the faith principle. Now, if God made a promise to you, God cannot take back that promise. And you can break your commitment with God. God will never break his commitment with you.
Amen.
If we leave God, he didn't leave us, we left him.
Amen.
But what happened when the young man told his father, said, I'm grown now, I want my inheritance. Mm-hmm. I'm going on down the road.
Mm-hmm.
I'm tired of this. You know, we're going to church every night. You know, I'm tired of this. I'm going to have me some fun. I say, here, take your inheritance. God will never stop you from leaving the church. Somebody need to listen to me. But when the young man left, and when he saw the reality of the world, as long as he had a pocket full of money, he had, oh, praise God, he had everything he wanted. Amen. And with high heel shoes.
All right.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Wearing the short skirts.
Mm-hmm.
Look how pretty I am. But when his money ran out, they ran out.
All right.
Hallelujah. He found himself literally living like a pig.
That's right.
He said, wait a minute. I'm going back home.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah.
And when he started back home, every day his father went down the road looking for him.
Mm-hmm.
He didn't go too far, he was looking for him.
Amen.
He never went after him.
Nope.
God will never go and make you leave whatever you want to do and make you come back to him. He never will, but he'll look for you to come back.
Right. Amen.
Now each person, hear me, has a cutoff point.
Amen.
God ain't going to keep looking day after day, year after year for you. Sooner or later, you're stuck.
Amen.
That's when trouble sets in. I'm talking about big time trouble.
Right, amen. Right.
When you have, and before any catastrophic event in your life, God will always send danger signs.
Mm-hmm.
Amen.
Dreams.
Amen.
An affliction in your body sometimes, and you say, wow, what's happening to me? And you pray and God move it. Something else comes back in your body, you pray and God moves it.
Yeah.
But sometimes, brother and sister, you need to take heed and realize, since God bought me with a price, since God chose me to come out from amongst them, maybe I need to get my act together and serve him.
Amen.
What is out there in the world for you?
Amen.
Liars?
Amen.
Cheaters?
Amen.
Amen.
Troublemakers,
amen.
All kind of trouble. People that totally have lost their mind if they're not in Holiness Church.
Amen.
I saw over the news, was it today?
Mm-hmm.
A man walked up to a policeman, read a ticket, shot me here twice, got his car and drove off.
Sure
did. And then the other day, some more police officers got shot in another part of the country. They lived, but people are going crazy.
Yeah.
The pressure's on them. Well, they'll blame anything. They didn't say they knew the policeman. They say he's one of the shooter policemen.
Amen.
pressure on him. People do strange things and pressure get on him. That's why God saved you to take the pressure off you. That's why he said,
Lord,
put your cares on me, for I help you.
Amen.
David wrote that psalm. Mm-hmm. Read that again, verse 2.
When the wicked, even my enemies and my foes, came upon me to eat of my flesh, they stumbled and fell. But a host should encamp against me, my heart shall not
fear. No matter what kind of trouble comes against you, if you stay in the church will always bring you out.
Amen.
Or God will bring you out because you stay in the church, and the church is God.
Glory, hallelujah.
Read.
My heart shall not fear, though war shall rise against me, and this will I be confident.
Now wait a minute. This shall I be confident. I said David had faith.
Amen.
If you're confident in something, that means you got faith to believe something.
Amen.
And this I have confidence in what?
One thing have I desired of the Lord, that I will seek after.
I'll seek after.
Amen.
I'll seek after.
Amen.
You can't leave that part out. When you seek after something, you're looking for something.
Yeah.
We're saved by faith. He was looking for something.
That I may dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life.
I will seek after to go to heaven, that I can stay in heaven all the days of my life.
To behold the beauty of the Lord and to inquire in his temple. For in the time of trouble he shall hide me in his pavilion. In the secret of his tabernacle shall he hide me.
In the secret of his church.
Amen.
He'll hide me. Why is it a secret? Because everybody can't find it.
Right.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Only the few can find it.
Amen.
It's a secret. The world can't come in here. Well, they can come in, but not in the actual spiritual church. They can come in the building. But in order for you to come to the spiritual church, you got to have the Spirit of God.
Amen.
And if you got the Spirit of God, that means you got faith in God. But if you ain't got faith in God, they deliver you from your circumstances, from your condition, that means you ain't got God.
Mm-hmm. All right.
But if you got faith to believe, then put aside worldly things.
Amen.
Things that you might think might please you.
All right.
Stop thinking about what burdens or what rules or regulation the church is putting on you and your life, hindering your life. You ain't got a life without God.
Amen.
You ain't got a life without the church. You already know that.
Amen.
Some of y'all done tried it. My goodness. Don't you understand?
Amen.
The world don't mean you no good.
No.
And the world, I'm not talking about the world, I'm talking about people in the world.
Right.
Amen.
God said, love not the world, neither the things of the world. For if you love the world, the love of God is not in you.
Mm-hmm.
Love not the world.
Right.
And I said before, he ain't talking about rivers and streams.
Mm-hmm.
Flowers.
Amen.
He's talking about people in the
Amen.
World who don't like you because you're in holiness and will talk you out of the holiness church if you allow it to happen.
Amen.
But I refuse to bow.
Amen.
When I was a young minister, praise God, before I was a minister, when I was a young brother in the church. And things would come against me, praise God. I sat on my con and cried and grit my teeth, praise God, and said,
Amen.
I'm not going to leave the church.
Amen.
And I'm still here.
Amen. Glory.
And I'm still trusting in God.
Yeah, right.
And it brought me a mighty long way.
Amen.
Through sicknesses,
Amen.
All kind of difficulties. Preachers stabbed me in the back.
Right.
Assistant pastors stabbed me in the back.
Right. Amen.
I'm still here.
Amen.
I believe you.
Amen.
Trusting in God.
Mm-hmm.
Believing in Him.
Right.
And every time I got sick, God stepped in and healed my body.
Amen.
By the time I got a little bit disturbed, I think on the voice of Jesus. He said, give me up. He said, I'll give you a perfect peace.
Amen.
He said, Pastor, don't understand. Can't figure it out.
Right.
But I'm happy.
Amen.
Ain't got nothing to be happy about. But I have. I got a covenant promise.
Amen.
David said, the Lord is my shepherd.
Right.
Thank you,
Jesus.
Start getting serious about church.
Amen.
And stop worrying about the world.
Amen.
Leave the world alone.
Amen.
Bible says be separate. Come out from amongst them.
Amen.
They don't mean you no good.
Mm-hmm.
relatives you think love you, they don't care 2 cents about you going to the church. But leave the church. Oh, I'm so glad. I've been praying for you to come out. You praying for me. I thought the Bible said God don't hear sinners' prayer.
Right.
Is that a word?
Amen.
Not my word, that's God's word.
Amen.
Don't be misled by foolish spirits.
Right.
And there are many of them out there.
Amen.
And if you know that you are faced with certain conditions and certain situations, that you're going to need divine intervention, and God already spoke to him, he already put this in your heart, then you need to cleave to God.
Amen.
And leave the world alone and be separate. Now they criticize us for being separate and for teaching separatism. I'm teaching separatism because God taught it.
Amen.
And the reason why he taught it, because he said if you fool around with them, they're going to cause you through clever words, vain speech, they'll cause you to leave away from me.
That's right.
So he said, leave them alone. Don't that make sense?
Amen.
You're gonna constantly tell me on the slide about your head covering, your dress. Mm-hmm. Amen. You don't have to dress like that. God still loves you.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, but God loves the obedient heart.
Mm-hmm.
Those who seek after him.
Yes.
If you seek after him, you're looking for him. That means you're gonna follow him when you find him.
Amen.
Amen.
All of these things, brothers and sisters, are put in the Bible. Because it's giving you some type of principle to develop a character that won't give up when the going gets tough. Leave because it's not popular.
Amen.
If you're waiting for the Holiness Church to get popular, you're in the wrong place.
Amen.
And I might say you're in the wrong place at the right time.
Amen.
Somebody just told me they had another earthquake in Japan.
Yeah.
And then we got 7 points on the wrist. That's I think the biggest one is 9. So you know it's pretty powerful. And I don't even know why them people want to stay in Japan. They happen once a year, at least once a year. God's trying to shake up something. Hindu worshiping, worshiping statues and Buddha worship, Shintoism and all that.
Amen. Lord.
People need to wise up.
Right.
When you hear the gospel message preached, run to the holy place. And this is a holy place. And when you see the events in the world, earthquakes in diverse places, when you see all that's taking place in the world, all these chaotic events, you need to run to the Holiness Church. And stay there. He said they got a flu epidemic that's headed this way. They don't know whether any medicine is to stop it or not. Better stay in church.
Amen.
You want no maniac to walk up to you and blow your brains out.
Amen.
Oh, she's depressed.
Amen.
He ain't got nothing there for, so he's going to kill you. Why don't you kill yourself?
Amen.
You that upset.
Amen.
They want to hurt somebody else.
Amen.
By hurting somebody else, it makes them feel better. They want to hurt the sanctified church because in criticizing the sanctified church, it seems to make them feel better.
Yeah.
So they go to the Baptist church and clap their hands and say, hallelujah. And their testimony ain't going no far in that wall.
Right.
You know, holler that wall? Amen. But that's as far as you want to say, as loud as you can holler. Church of God is real. The word of God is real. And somebody needs to take heed. Stop playing. Stop playing church. God loves you, and he showed his love for you by allowing you to escape certain events and situations that you know would have brought you down, destroyed you, put you in a hospital room, maybe forever, in a prison cell, maybe forever, in a condition in your life, maybe forever.
Amen.
But he delivered you, didn't he?
Amen. Lord.
He can't make you love him.
Amen.
But he can show you certain events. And then he can also move objects out of your pathway to let you know I love you.
Amen.
Some of us ain't got no business being here right today. Should be in a crisis grave right now. Some of us. But we're here.
Thank you,
God. Let us sing. I need.
Take a little time and pray for me.
$50.
Amen.
Brother Kelly, $100.
Amen.
Anybody pray for me?
Jesus' name.
Jesus' name.